have raised concerns among emerging political parties of the excessive influence of the military and former ruling party elements in politics.
On Sunday, Egyptians went to the polls in a referendum on constitutional reforms. The vote was the Egyptians' first post-Mubarak democratic experience. Only 41% of the 45 million eligible voters turned out at the polling stations, meaning over 26 million people chose not to cast their ballots. The country's former constitution, drafted in 1971, was suspended by the Supreme Military Council 2 days after ex-President Hosni Mubarak was driven from office. More than 14 million voters, or 77% of the eligible voters, approved the constitutional amendments, while around 4 million voted against the reforms. The Supreme Council of the Armed Forces appointed a special committee for amending the constitution. The 11-member committee drafted the amendments in just 10 days and offered it for public discussion within only 3 weeks. Officials say the referendum will pave the way for parliamentary and presidential elections within 6 months and will help the establishment of a new political system. The vote will reduce Egypt's unlimited 6-year presidential tenure to 2 4-year terms. But members of the emerging political groups in Egypt who voted against the proposed amendments are critical of the hastily assembled constitution. They believe the changes are insufficient. These people, who played a key part in the Egyptian revolution, want a new constitution to be written from scratch before any election is held. In fact, members of nascent political parties think in the absence of an effective political organization, they won't stand a chance against the more organized political groups in the future. They have also voiced their concern that under the current circumstances, the remnants of the former ruling party, the National Democratic Party, could once again seek to dominate Egypt's politics. Still, the vote's outcome indicates the strength of the military and established political organizations versus the emerging political groups and their aspirations to bring about change.
Now, the leader of Iran's Islamic